Welcome to Drawfee, where we take your dumb ideas
and make even dumber drawings.
I'm Jacob.
I'm Nathan.
I'm Karina.
And I'm Julia.
And y'all ever hear about when two people got the same name?
Are they married? Are we allowed to ship them?
Y'all ever hear about when two people, unrelated and unmarried, happen to have the same name?
Twins.
Twins.
You know when you name your twins the same
name,
but they're unrelated?
What, y'all don't do that?
I've not named my twins the same name yet. No.
It's like the Olsen twins. They're both named Olsen.
Yeah.
Olsen, Olsen, and Olsen, Olsen. But you know who else got the same names?
Mario.
And Luigi Mario.
Okay. It's Miyazaki. It's the Ghibli Miyazaki and it's the Elden Ring Miyazaki. They both have the name Miyazaki.
Oh.
And we're not the first ones to notice this.
I didn't know they were twins.
They're twins. Two geniuses. The person who noticed this first was from our YouTube comment section. They're named Raven Rain. And they said, Miyazaki x Miyazaki. I would love to see you guys combine Elden Ring and Studio Ghibli characters or draw one in the other's style.
Wow.
And we thought that was a fine idea. So we're going to honor the Miyazaki twins today.
That's a fine idea.
It's a pretty fine idea.
Fine enough for an episode.
I mean, it's whatever.
It'll do.
It's a speed draw. I just want to start. I have to edit this and I just want to start.
Let's start.
Going first?
Nathan's going first. You know that. You know Nathan's going first.
I'm going first.
Nathan.
I'm Nathan.
Nathan?
Tell us what you did.
This is another in a series of Nathan speed draws where he takes the option to not draw a humanoid character.
Whoa!
So I drew the cat bus from Totoro.
We love that bus.
As a Dark Souls.
Yeah.
I don't think we're going to like that bus anymore.
It might be a little bit of a scary bus.
Well, let's find out. You ready to get into it?
Hop aboard.
Okay.
This is your stop.
3, 2, 1, go.
So here is me trying to draw the cat bus, but scary.
Ooh.
So I looked up. First thing I did was look up if there are just sort of cats in Dark Souls, and it turns out there are.
Yes.
There's a cat called Alvira.
Alvina. Fuck. What the hell's wrong with you?
Get out of here, you fake fan.
I like cats.
I have to leave. I've ruined the episode already.
Actually, edit. Just saw that they corrected Nathan.
Alvina. Well, anyway, there's a cat called Alvina, and so I kind of was using that as sort of a benchmark for this, and then also I had this idea for sort of like a gaping dragon sort of aesthetic where the bus part on top has sort of decayed away over the years, and it leaves behind this sort of rib cage that that the skeletons can ride in.
Just like a real bus.
Basically just like a real bus. I put the little rat skulls up there where the little mice lights that they have.
Did you say that skeletons ride inside this cat bus?
Yes.
That's adorable.
Yeah. So my idea for this boss, in game would be it's an optional boss. It's basically a wandering spawner.
Yeah,
that you can choose to avoid, or you can try and fight it. But it just, you know, it follows a set route like a bus, and if you cross paths with it, a bunch of skeletons get off and start chasing.
They're all have little briefcases.
Yeah,
and they're like grumbling.
They're on their way to work, and their job is to beat your ass. I figured it'd be called something like transportation homunculus or something, and so I made the bus stop sign that's on the front, sort of like that would be its sort of arcane heart, because that tells it where it's going.
Yeah.
And so the way you start the boss fight is you have to you destroy that, and then it doesn't have a direction anymore, and so it just starts fighting you instead.
I love this lighting.
That's cool lore, Nathan.
That's the lore I came up with. And then, yeah, I wanted to do sort of like a more loose painterly style. I was originally going to do it in Clip Studio, but then I downloaded a bunch of brushes, and then Clip Studio was like, you need to update Clip Studio if you want to use any of these brushes. So I was like, I don't have time.
Can't.
I'm going to miss my bus, my cat bus. So I just did it in Photoshop. It worked pretty good.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's looking great.
I spent a lot of time on these teeths, and then I make them pretty dark later, so...
That's life.
That's just how it goes. I really like the sort of headlights eyes, so yeah, I wanted those
really
to
popping.
Be
yeah.
real poppy. Just like the lights coming off the beast.
Yeah.
Also, because it has multiple leggies, I looked up. There's a monster in Dark Souls called. Please let me get this right. It's called Deep Accursed.
That sounds right. That's generic enough, but
Elvira.
I don't know.
It's Elvira.
It's Elvira.
Pronounced Luffy.
It's pronounced Luffy. And they've got these sort of tarantula legs with sort of mammalian paws at the end. And so
those things are horrific.
I kind of borrowed that for these legs because it is sort of insect-like with all the leggies. And this is sort of a pose that I took from... Totoro, where he's on top of the house and they're waving at him.
But you don't want to wave at this.
You don't want to wave at this because again, the skeletons are gonna they're gonna come for you.
Yeah, they get paid commission for the number of asses they beat. So they're gonna be really after you.
I'd still risk it. I like it.
So yeah, you know, this was pretty fun. I like drawing a creature. I've discovered I feel freer to experiment when it's a creature than when it's a humanoid.
Sure.
I don't know why. I guess I'm just more comfortable messing around with creatures.
And there's like less rules.
Yeah.
Since it's a creature, you can be like, that's just how the creature is.
That's just how the creature looks.
What are you going to do? Correct me?
It's my creature.
I love the lighting on that. On those rocks.
Yeah. Thank you.
And I love the pop of the red.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. It's so cool. Basically everything is sort of a muted blue gray except for the things that give off light.
Oh, that was a cool little depth added to the heart.
Yeah.
I was about to beat your ass for muting it, but then you made it nice and bright again. And
I wanted to mute the sort of stuff coming off of it to have some.
Yeah,
like a magical glow from inside, and then I add a little
it
reflected
looks so
light.
Good.
And then at some point, I accidentally move. Yeah, see there, everything moves, and I'm like, "What happened?"
No,
so I'm try and get everything back in place.
Been there though.
But yeah, this was fun. Like it, I started off doing a bunch of layers for the background and shading and highlights, and then I ended up just sort of merging them all together and. Sort of just painting.
Yeah, it's fun to do.
And now I'm going to redo the background. Make it sort of more like we're looking up at it. Change the curve of the...
Yeah, I like that.
The gradient.
Oh, look at those boids.
Add a little moon, some clouds. And yeah, like this is one that I feel like I could have just kept working on and like fiddling with it because I'd keep reaching a point where like this could maybe be done and then I'd go no I want to add a little bit more and so I sort of had to force myself to stop tell myself it was good enough and yeah I'm still going.
Place his hand over your own hand. It's time to stop.
You gotta stop, much like the bus. Still going.
It simply must.
I think that's it.
Excellent.
Yeah.
God, so cool.
So that's a creepy, creepy cat bus. You can fight it if you want.
I do want to. Let's go.
I don't, but I will meow at it.
It's gonna fight you if you meow at it.
I'll take that chance.
Yeah, this is so cool. You've been doing so many cool painty things lately.
Yeah.
It's fun to see.
I just want to draw a scary creature, it turns out. This is my Nathan draws scary creatures arc. on Drawfee.
It's a good arc. Yeah.
Scary era.
Scary era.
Scara.
Well, I'm up next. Ooh. And I'm pretty sure I'm the only one who drew Elden Ring characters in a Ghibli style. Is this correct?
We get it, Jacob. Yeah. You're a gamer.
I'm the only one who did it. I heeded the call when everyone else was too afraid.
Yeah. I can't draw Ghibli style.
I don't know anything.
I do know everything. And what I chose to do
nerd
was take inspiration from the Princess Mononoke poster and except instead do it with Ronnie and Blythe, since it's also a woman and a wolf guardian. There's a lot of parallels there.
Oh.
So let's get into it. 3, 2, 1, go. So there you go. There's the Princess Mononoke movie cover poster thing. And there's Ronnie in the top left and Blythe. And I thought about it and immediately saw the parallels. And I was like, this is the way to go. This is how we're doing it.
Nice.
So I tried to sort of mimic the Ghibli style faces.
Yeah.
And like simplify a lot of the details because Elden Ring's really like textural and complex.
Yep.
And Ghibli is very, very simple and more shapey. So I was just trying to copy that style. I do more sketch layers in this than I normally do. You see, I'm already on the second sketch layer.
Ooh.
Normally I just do one, but I think I do like three or four in this in various places just to like try and get things right.
You nailed that wolf face.
Thank you. It was fun trying to do something more like, I don't normally work with this many lines. It's more lines than I'm used to. So it was fun trying to get those like facial details, like the scrunch of the snout and stuff like that.
That's so cool. I love watching you draw anything fluffy and fuzzy.
I got the fluff within me.
Yeah.
But I was trying to eventually I'll mimic it closer the way that it looks in the Ghibli version. I guess I took a break here. Yeah,
can
here's
I ask a lore question?
Sure.
Is the wolf fella, like, is he a wolf or is he just a guy wearing a wolf head?
He is a wolf. He's an actual wolf man.
How cute. Okay, carry on. I've seen a lot of fan art of these two.
Yeah, they're fan favorites for sure, and for good reason. They've got like the biggest sort of side character storyline associated with them. So you get a lot of them if you play through their story. In Elden Ring, and it's I think probably the most popular of the endings too of the game revolves around these characters because the game's got a bunch of different endings you can get. Yeah, a lot of my time was spent getting these like fur textures just right.
Yeah, they look really good.
Yeah.
Once again, it's the good pen.
Yeah, I was just leaning in to see what pen you were using.
But I was using it more this way, like an actual pen. I usually go bigger on my brush sizes, so I get more variation, but that doesn't really...
Yeah, because I figured it was the good pen, but it looks different the way you're using it in this one.
It's crazy how versatile that pen is.
Yeah.
You can do so much with it. It's why I like it. It always has a lot of character to
it. It's good.
It's a good pen.
It's a good pen.
It's a good pen.
We say it every
People
time.
People are going to be sick of hearing about
I've
it.
I've been using the okay pen.
So I think the inks on this were probably what I was most happy with. I felt like I really nailed what I was going for.
Yeah.
I think I lose some of it in the colors.
Oh.
But I'm really happy with how it comes out overall in the end. But there was a period where I was unhappy with it in the middle once... I start doing colors,
Got the way.
This is hand hell.
She has many.
She got four hands, and you know she's got the hands that are steepled and the ones that are in the had to do it to him pose.
What are you looking at? Four hands.
Yeah. Right there, I was using that fill tool.
Oh,
you can download
with the ice cream.
Yeah, the ice cream one. It's really incredible. You could just like lasso an area and it'll just like fill it. It detects. I don't even know how it does it because all my inks were on the same layer, right? Mm-hmm. But I lassoed around Ronnie vaguely and it knew exactly what to fill without going into Blythe's territory.
Oh. Yeah.
It's really helpful.
Yeah, it's a. I love that. It saved me so much time on my inking.
Yeah,
I mean it's coloring. A, yeah, whatever.
Flatting, flatting, basing.
I don't know.
Whatever.
I'm not an artist.
So I started doing lighting in one way, and then I stop and I change it and I do it all a different way. So this is all going to go away.
Nice.
What I end up doing is I put a hard light layer over everything, and then I delete out.
Oh, cool.
Because the base colors were already fairly dark. And so I was like, I don't think they need more shadow because they're already kind of shadow.
Yeah.
So I was like, I'll make a big bright light and then I'll delete out the shadows and then I reduce the intensity of the light later. I just have it this bright so I can see what I'm doing easily.
Nice. Yeah. This is a cool effect.
And I'll do the same thing with the shadows as well later. When I add some extra shadows, I go really dark with them just so I can see better and then adjust it later, which can just make it a little easier. But you have to go through a phase where it looks a little weird.
That's art. Baby.
You, baby. You stupid baby.
Love this wolf. He's so expressive.
Yeah, I was really happy with how he came out.
He's so cute.
I did stealthily get rid of his sword.
He didn't feel like drawing.
You're
that.
So valid.
The sword's hilt is so ornate. And I was like, I already spent longer on this than I usually do. It was like 3.5 hours for me, which for me is long.
Wow.
just because I get like tired of doing it and I don't want to do it anymore. It's like I have to reach a good point before
that's
then.
About how long I took on mines, and I was like, wow, short one.
But you're accustomed to like working on pieces longer. I'm still getting used to doing like multi-day processes.
But that's cool.
So here I just do a pretty rough background that approximates the background of that Ronnie image on the top left.
Yeah.
Ronnie's tower and like the view outside the back. Because I know I'm going to blur it and darken it anyways. So it doesn't really need to be too terribly detailed. And then I add a little glow to the light. I add a little, I use a big soft brush to like darken some areas to get some gradation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Then I darken the background more. I use the blur tool to blur it out a bit around the edges. And then I start adding some effects, some auto actions, Karina.
Yay!
They've got a line blur one and a retro effect.
You got that line haze?
Got that line haze.
I use that one on mine too.
And then I added the film grain on top of that.
Nice.
And so this is the final product. I think it ended up looking kind of VHS-y and cool in that sort of way.
Well, I believe this was a screenshot from a Ghibli.
Then my work was successful.
Yeah, this looks great.
Thank you. Yeah, I was really pleased with the wolf most of all. Because I don't usually draw animals that much, so I felt like he came out really good.
He has such a good snoot.
You want to boop it.
I want
to boop, that thing.
I want to be like, calm down, sweaty. You're going to get all wrinkly.
I'd boop it, but I'd be afraid of getting chomped.
Yeah, you don't want to get chomped. I'm done.
Great work.
Wow.
Karina is next.
That's me.
Tell us about it.
You might have heard this one recently on TikTok. Welcome to another episode of... Hey, I still don't know what Elden Ring Souls game aesthetics are, even though we talk about it every time we do one of these episodes.
Fair.
Because it's largely like gothic fantasy adjacent-esque type stuff, which is not a genre I'm into. So it's all very confusing to me. Anyway, that's why I didn't do an Elden Ring character. I don't know many of them, but I do know Yubaba from Spirited Away.
Oh, she's my a scary God. Lady.
Yeah, and that's my favorite Ghibli movie. So I wanted to do a character from Spirited Away, but I didn't want to do No Face. I thought that was like an easy one. So I wanted to do Yubaba because I think she's just the cutest.
Yeah, she's good.
I love her.
Shall we get going?
We can get going.
Let's get going. 3, 2, 1, go.
Yeah, so this is another one where I was just completely indecisive about what I wanted to do. So I put it off until this morning. And then I just kind of like said, fuck it, I'll just do something. So I just kind of started drawing with no real plan, just looking at a bunch of pictures of you, Baba. And again, I don't know like what the aesthetic is. I had my friend Joey send me a bunch of Elden Ring bosses, and they kind of range from like horrific creature to just a guy. So yeah. I went more creature route because she has like a lot of bird motif. Like she's kind of bird shaped and she has like little bird minions and she can shape shift into a silly little bird. So I went with a bird creature theming, which ended up just being the harpy from The Last Unicorn is where I drew this this design from largely, because yeah. they both have the big pillowy titties and I was like cool, but and they're both birdie, so I wanted to make her more of a bird creature, so that's just kind of what I did.
I love just, these lines.
It's just kind of her but more bird like yeah. It gave her a big poofy. I made her all poofy and stuff.
I want to yeah. tell you, Karina, you're on point more than you know, because in Elden Ring, there are some horrific bird abominations and some horrific bat abominations that kind of look like this.
There's some bird abominations that have blades taped to their talons.
Yeah, well, I guess because, again, I'm just kind of making all this up based on very little. So I think my concept here is that she's like unassuming. Like you think she's just like an old lady with a big head. But then it turns out she's like a scary harpy lady.
Yeah,
like I like that.
Yeah,
like, that feels like it tracks.
I wanted to give her wings and then I just gave her more hands because that felt about right. I think
totally
for the aesthetic, it gave her little harpy feet. Because she's like a witch and she can shapeshift. So like, I think when the wings are down, they look like a cape, but then they like open up and look like wings. So I have it kind of going between fabric and feathers.
I feel like every time you're like, I don't know what Elden Ring, I don't know what Dark Souls is. And then you like nail with like weird specificity a lot of the facets of yeah. the style.
I mean, I source a lot of reference from my friends who play Elden Ring. I was largely looking at, as my friend Joey calls him, Margit the Noob Fucker. So, yeah. And this is where I also use the ice cream guy. Before anyone asks, this is like the autofill action. Its icon is a little ice cream man, and it's like always on the top free Clip Studio
yes.
list. Like it's just generally there. Just look for it.
If you search Phil and sort by popular, it's right up there at the yeah. top.
Yeah, and there's a little ice cream man.
This is Philip, the ice cream man.
Yeah. So then I wanted to do, because I know Elden Ring has like it's all realistic looking, so I went with a more painterly style for this one because I was like, I'll do like the lighting effects later, but I just kind of wanted to get this all smoothed in,
get it all sorted out.
Yeah, I got me this is my favorite brush. I don't think it's free anymore, but I just like how it has the right amount of drag.
Yeah, it looks really nice.
And just to make sure it's not like mixing with any of the other colors outside of the skin, I do have the skin on its own layer while I'm painting it, and then I just merge everything down as I go. So that's why everything looks kind of very separated still. But yeah, so and I made one of her eyes super clouded just because that also felt like an aesthetic choice they would make in Elden Ring based on the pictures I was sent.
You're not wrong.
But yeah, so I kind of just pulled like ooh. From yeah, I gave her like what is it called, like a plumage,
frock?
Yeah,
a floof.
Yeah, she's just a big bird. She's just a big bird. But yeah. So I like to think that she folds the wings in and it looks like a shawl or something, but then she's actually just a big scary bird. But yeah, and I always liked the I always liked her character. And even though she's like the big scary antagonist, I like never found her that scary. Oh, I always man. Found her to be a very comforting presence. Wow. Like at the part in Spirited Away where the stink spirit comes and they and like she starts helping Chihiro with the stink spirit. I'm just like, wow, how parental. I love her.
They're working together.
I don't know. I just think she's neat. So I wanted to do her because I also just think she has such a great design. Yeah.
She's like your friend's cranky grandma.
Yeah, like not my mommy figure, so I love her. Yeah. We all need to have like a chaotic Tita in our lives. I think that's why I like her. She gives me chaotic Tita vibes.
Interesting. I remember having such a visceral reaction to seeing this character when Spirited Away first came out and just like being absolutely terrified of it.
I mean, I was scared of Spirited Away because I would see ads for it in the newspaper, and then I put line haze, and then I added some glowy. And then I saw, like, the, not novelization, but, like, a picture book version of it at the bookstore, and I thought it was, like, so fucking scary. But then one of my friends was like, you should actually watch it, and then I watched it, and I was like, actually, this is my favorite movie of all time.
She's the kind of grandma that will yell at you for being sick, but also give you cough drops and
yeah. I don't know. I just think she's neat.
I love the lighting effect.
Oh, yeah, it's so cool.
And I didn't know what to do for backgrounds, but she's just somewhere.
Yeah. Everything's yeah. always in a damn haze and, or a fog anyways. Yeah,
this is another, hey, I don't know how to actually write Japanese. I just copied this from a screenshot, so I don't know if it looks remotely correct, but I like to think she does a thing where she captures the name and maybe that's like the weapon.
That's
all
cool.
The names she stole. I don't know.
Well, there is a weapon in Elden Ring that's like script.
Right. Yeah, it looks just like the script that you drew coming off the end of a sword.
Nailing it on accident as per usual.
Every time.
Yeah, but yeah, this is my mommy.
So cool.
We love you, mommy. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for being passive aggressive and mean to me.
Happy late Mother's Day, mommy.
Give me back my name, mommy.
Thanks.
I don't want to be Olsen anymore.
Yeah, that's why they all have the same name. She keeps taking their actual names and then just being like, Olsen? Yeah, I named the last three Olsen.
Oh, whatever. They're all Olsen to me.
She's your cranky high school teacher that's like, I'm not going to remember your name. Everyone's getting the same nickname.
Hey! But yeah, so.
Yeah, this is awesome.
Yeah,
the painting is so nice looking. And
love
the lighting. Did you use that pencil for the lines? The like
the one I sent you? I think so.
That's what it looked like to me.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was the one I sent you.
The one that's called like it looks like a real pencil or something. Maybe. Is like its name.
I can't believe it's not pencil.
Yeah.
It pencil.
Yeah, this is rad. I can't believe you did this morning. I'm so mad.
I mean, my clock is on the screen recording.
I mean, I do believe it, but I don't want to believe it.
It would take an extra click for me to get rid of that. So it's there for all the world to see.
Well, let's hit the last one. It's Julia.
Woo. It's me.
What you did?
I did Howl from Howl's Moving Castle.
Oh, ooh,
another bird. Oh my God.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I did it. I feel very neutral about this piece. I was very head empty because behind the scenes, I was also working on the same day on the Draw Detectives finale. So my brain was very split.
Let's just look at it. Let's get it rolling. All right. 3, 2, 1, go.
So my kind of story that I did for this, by the way, my new tactic for thumbnailing is to take the canvas and then just make it really small.
Hell
so it's like the size of a thumbnail.
Hell yeah.
And then go from there. My story is if the main character from Howl's Moving Castle did not say, come find me in the future. Sophie's her name. If he, you know, was kind of left to his own devices and had to, you know, was stuck in this sort of war world that's going on and is trying his best to protect Calcifer, but gets like obsessive over protecting Calcifer, who is his heart, during this, you know, tumultuous war.
Yeah, that tracks. There's a lot of Elden Ring and Souls bosses who become evil through becoming obsessed over something.
Yeah. Yeah. So Howl is a really good sort of one. It was almost cheating to do Howl because he's so one-to-one with Dark Souls themes. But like I said, I was a little preoccupied. So I was like, yeah, I'll take it. I'll take this one.
Yeah.
But yeah, I want him to be sitting sort of like in the rubble of his house. Like, because I just imagine that the war got worse and worse and worse because the prince who's stuck as a scarecrow, spoilers, is never found. And, you know, Howl never wins. So the war just gets worse and he's trying to protect his heart, but everyone's trying to recruit him to the war because he's a big, powerful magician wizard guy. So yeah, he just kind of gets stuck in his monster form, like he's starting to in the movie, but is, you know, real scraped up. So I had to learn how to do feathers for this because it's a lot of feathers, and I wanted to do a style that was kind of like the Elden Ring intro, which is really loose. I was trying to imagine how the announcer says Howl.
Howl, the crow of the castle.
Yeah.
Oh, tarnished.
Oh, my God.
Poor Alu.
I love that announcer. He goes so hard. But, oh, maybe it's like Howl the flame heart or something.
Oh.
I got to rewatch this movie. I remember watching it and being like, I don't understand what's happening.
Well, it's a whole thing where the one kingdom is convinced that the other kingdom has kidnapped their prince. But really, what just happened was that the prince fell under a spell and became a scarecrow. And the scarecrow lives with Howl.
That'll happen.
You know how it is.
You gotta watch out for that.
And Howl's really powerful, so everyone's trying to recruit him to the war, but Howl doesn't want to fight in it because he's like, leave me alone, I'm just a little guy.
I just want to dye my hair.
Yeah, I'm too fabulous for this.
making me want to rewatch it.
Yeah, and then he meets Sophie, and Sophie kind of lives to help other people in a way and is trying to find her own place in life because she always kind of views herself as like, the boring one.
And she gets oldified.
And then she gets put under a curse where she turns old.
Why does everyone get cursed all the time?
I don't know. There's a lot of cranky witches and wizards and magicians and stuff going on.
We've been put under the never stop honking outside curse.
Yeah, that's true. What witch is mad at us?
Yeah, someone's doing an amazing job with their timing on that honk because it is the same every time.
Yeah.
But yeah, like I said, I was trying to mimic the style of the intro, and they do a lot of samey, like single color palette thing where it's like, you know, grayish blues, or if you're looking at Dung Eater, some real warm oranges.
Like dung.
Honk if you love dung.
Honk if you love dung.
Especially eating it.
Honk, you coward.
But I felt like a lot of elements were getting lost, so you start to see me pushing and pulling a lot of the colors, trying to make things pop or whatever. I also just keep looking at these feathers and thinking that they're not clean enough. I'm trying not to be clean in this piece, which is really hard for me.
Whoa. The jump scare.
Yes.
Oh,
this is me trying
the
to
depth.
Do some pushing and some pulling.
Yeah.
Ah.
This is, I was doing an inverted color thing where it's like, if you look at something for a long time, if you want to see if things are blending too much, you invert the colors.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah. Cause then, and then you can look at your scale of, you know, your dark to light, and it shows you how much it's leaning in one direction. And all of my values were bunched up on one side. So I wanted to start spreading it out. So I had some lights and some, you know, at least some pops. I just had like no light colors. So, but yeah, the style for the intro cinematic is really, really loose and painterly. And that is hard for me. I want everything to be precise and clean.
So you made a little challenge for yourself.
Yeah. Yeah, I did.
Well, this looks great.
I also
a piece that you feel medium about is like so intricate and cool looking. And
oh, thank you.
Some like I did a creature and put it mostly in shadow because I did not want to detail a bunch of fur or feathers. These feathers look great.
Thank you. It was it took a lot of pushing and pulling, but I like where the feathers wound up. Yeah. The other thing I was doing was that I kind of challenged myself to only use Ross Draw's brush pack because...
Shout outs.
Yeah, because that brush pack has so many good textures in it. And I wanted to try to use... I'm going to go outside and pop those tires.
What is happening?
But yeah, that's my piece. I wanted to use the textures that he had.
Julia, this is so cool.
It's rules.
It's really, really good,
Julia. I love the warms.
Thank you. Yeah, I wanted to...
Big hands.
I know that the intro pieces all sort of lean like blue to white sort of things, and they stay kind of like grayish, but I didn't like how
the values
turned out.
That's what makes the use of the orange so good.
Yeah, it really draws.
So that's why
I
added the orange. Yeah. But it's not true to the cinematic.
Maybe the cinematic should take some of your advice and maybe then it'll look better.
Cinematic is wrong.
Cinematic is wrong.
Julia Wright, cinematic wrong.
But yeah, he's just sitting in the rubble of his house with his hands kind of, he has these like big crow claws.
Yeah.
These talons and it's wrapped around, you know,
the way you drew them feels very Dark Souls.
Thank you.
Yeah,
to
totally.
Me.
I was trying.
Someone who does not play Dark Souls.
That's a Dark Souls to me.
That's Dark Souls to me.
Wow. Yeah, Jacob, you were the only one who did a Ghibli style.
Sorry, Jacob.
Wow. Everyone is laughing at me and pointing at me and whispering behind my back and saying hurtful things and tweeting about me and honking their horns.
No, that person only honked during my
They were going bonkers.
Because they're done honkers now, apparently. Maybe.
They were going mad honkers. But I think we all kind of went mad honkers on these pieces. And look at how good we did.
Yeah, I guess that's true. That's a really good point.
Yeah, did you think about that?
Yeah.
Amazing.
So I think it all makes sense.
Really good mad honkers.
Yeah.
To everyone.
And if you went mad honkers for this episode, like and subscribe.
Honk the subscribe button, honk the like.
And if you really went mad honkers,
leave a honk in the comments.
Subscribe to our patreon.com/drawfee so that we can keep making pieces that people keep honking at in the streets.
Yeah, and during the talking about the pieces.
Yeah, where we can edit.
And if you want to honk at us live or place a curse on us that will make us old, we stream on Twitch.
Monday nights, 7 p.m.
Yeah.
Watch us age before your very eyes.
Yes. And if you find yourself the subject of a curse that changes your form in some way and maybe you need some new clothes, check out our merch store.
You can put them on your honkers.
Oh, my God.
We're sorry.
Sorry.